gonna turn down my volume a bit. Oh, you can still hear my fan on. Sorry. I'll just turn that off so it's easier to hear me. There we go. Alright then. Hi guys. I know. Like, 2 spontaneous streams in a week. What a riot. But I got bored and I decided, you know what? I'm gonna try and make an animation using my logo. My little cat. My Kate Cat logo. I'm not entirely sure what I'm actually gonna do with it. I knew that I wanted the cat to come on from off the side of the screen and then bat a ball of yarn and something happen. So, you know. I'm not entirely sure what to do with it. But you know what? Trust the process, I suppose. This is what I've done already. So I've got these written down. I've got the first and second movement done, but I think I'm gonna try to do them on separate pieces. So I can, you know, focus on separate movements, because I'm pretty sure there's like 3 acts to the movement. There's gonna be the cat approaching the yarn, looking disinterested and walking away before turning back, which is the second movement. Something happens here, making them jump and landing here. Then they hesitate before going back to the yarn. I still have the fucking thing on vibrate. Jeez. Yeah, I've got like the first and second movement down, but I'm not sure what's gonna happen here. I don't know. I have the first and second movement down, which is great, so I'm just gonna do the little stop motion bits for each, you know, thing. I've nicknamed the cat Cake Kitty. Well, it is called Cake Kitty because that's what it fucking is. I haven't actually got a name for it yet. But, I've kind of, like, I decided like 5 minutes ago I'm nicknaming it Bean because the way I came up with it was I drew a bean shape and then I was like, oh hell yeah, this could make an excellent cat. So, we have, you go that way, you question the yarn. Go from there to there. Question it. Question it. You're looking this way. But you're gonna move that way. I'm gonna put like eyes on it so I can like tell the direction it's looking. So that's movement one. Then movement two is that same ball, but looking this way. Hesitantly approaching. It baps it here. Then we're gonna have you. Shoot up here, and then down to here. Basics of animation, ladies and gentlemen. So it's a little bit like, obviously like a naive sketch, but it's like string yarn. That was the idea I had for it, the premise. That's it. I'm not entirely sure of where else I could go with this. Cause okay, so we have the first movement. Close. I'm gonna name this movement one. I have to do that little weird one because it doesn't register that it's a one, otherwise it registers it as a lowercase l. Oh, for the love of monument. It's not even a monument, it's a fucking movement. Two. Note a Z. 2. I'm gonna merge them. I feel like that'll make it easier for navigating. Is literally just the investigation. Then it's coming back, bapping the ball, then being alarmed and jumping. I'm gonna alarm. Because the fucking yarn did something. Once I've got like all the movements and stuff settled, and the actual cat drawn, I may do middle frames, because these are all like the basic frames that I need to do. Which is introduction to the item. Movement 2 is introduction to the issue with said item. And movement 3 needs to be quote unquote resolve. But if I do need more, I do have like the extras just in case. Maybe like invert the colors? That could be it. I could invert the colors. Okay, so movement 2 ends here. This is the end of movement 2. I'm gonna number them. So movement 1 has 1. 1. 2, 3, 4. Actually, I'll just put them on the freaking thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 keyframes. Movement 2. Did them here. Movement 2 has 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5. Also 6 key frames. So should movement 3 have 6 keyframes? Probably should have storyboarded this beforehand, but you know. I got bored, so I decided, you know what? Let's try and make an animation. So, movement 3 needs to be slow. Very slow, very cautious. Because it's like reapproaching the item. So it's gonna be circle. Closer. 3. Where should 3 sit? So you have 2 slow movements towards the yarn. Right? Where should I put it? What should I do with this? Goes up here. Three. So disgruntled. And then right. Bap. Bap. Alarm. Okay, so let's start writing down like movement 1 curious oh no confusion confusion you have caused confusion and delay confusion investigation. I'm gonna move that a bit. So curious investigation. And then we'll move to disinterest. Disinterest. Then we move on to movement 2. Thank you. moment. Second thoughts. Let's move that up a bit. Second is hesitant. Hesitant. One second, folks. Okay, there we go. Anyway, as I was saying, yeah, so we have movement 3. I want to happen. Movement 3. One. Yawn. One. See? That right there. Little apart. apostrophe. I'm gonna add an extra movement. I'm going to add green. I'm going to do an extra movement, which is going to be zoom in. On all of these. I'm gonna put cat ears on this one. Cat ears. One. Significantly less cool, but it's not supposed to be. I'm gonna just go with the one I did had before. Oof. and it's circle again. It was purple, is the movement. I think I have this sorted. Cool. Right then. How long is this? Just 35 minutes. Okay then. I'm wondering if this is going to be one of my short streams. It probably will be. Probably will be one of my shorter streams. Could have done this earlier in the day, but you know, whatever. Just gonna lay down a bit. And tilt the mic down. Hello. Okay. So we have the basis for movements. Movement. Wait, no, this is. This is movement 4. Movement 4. This is movement 5. There we go. Alright, so we're gonna steadily go through them. Gonna add cat ears to all of these, just so, you know. Makes more sense. Movement one. Cat ears. 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 I'm doing all the outside because they're a little sparsely created. Obviously the ears are back. The way they're looking. I'm gonna just do that. Because, you know. Then this already has cat ears on it. Then there's the poof. And then there's the human. Since the cat and the human icons are actually interchangeable, I'm just using this, like, I'm using this as just like a base. Okay, I'm not sure. I think, you know what? No, I think I'll stick with just the line. I think I'll just stick with just the line. Okay, I need to add a reference image. This is a cake cat, aka Bean. My little icon. Use that as a as a reference. As you can see, Bean is kind of the pastel yellow. Mostly because I was trying to go for like a vanilla cake. I did draw all my friends as cake cats. And once I figure out how, I'm gonna try and make little things that walk across the bottom of the stream thing, the actual screen, that are like little cake cats. Because I don't have very many. I could just... Hang on a moment. I made a fucking stamp. I didn't even need the reference image. I have a goddamn stamp. Ugh. My dumbass. I made this so that I could, like, stamp it on works and stuff. I'm not going to. I made it for the sake of making it. Oh. I'm an idiot. I really am. I didn't even need to get the reference image. Oh, Christmas stick. Small enough. Can I just like do this whole animation using Bean as the outline for Bean? Yes. Oh. I could. I so could. Oh, that is like monumentally dumb. Thing is, I don't have any other reference image for Bean other than this like stamped image, which is literally just the TIF I made, because all sketchbook stuff is saved via TIF files. It's literally the TIF. I removed the background, like I made it invisible, then saved it or converted it to PNG, and then made it a stamp. Stream for at least an hour, but if I get called down before then I'll have no choice but to leave, because I have strict parents. Well, my dad's pretty strict anyway. Let's do the improvements. dinner in 10 minutes. Okay, so... so I don't have all that long. Bean is literally a combination of a cat and a bean. That is... yeah, that's the reason I'm calling it Bean. Because it's a combo of a cat and a bean. I'm gonna make the movement faded or lighter so that I can actually, you know, see what I'm doing with Bean. So I want to have Bean's tail look like a question mark. As it does in the original image, it looks very much like a question mark, which is the kind of thing I want to keep, because this thing is a curious cat. God, that looks like a fucking squirrel tail. Circles. By no means am I trying to make an anatomically correct cat. I will have you know. Thank you. Don't know why I'm sneezing, I'm not cold. Somebody be walking on my grapes. I ain't hearing no dinners ready. Movement 1 done. Movement 2. Actually, we need to draw the movements on. interest. Clutch brow. Even though they don't have brows. Because it's a fucking cat. Cats don't have eyebrows. Okay, movement two. Now what? Got an hour of fucking stuffing. Let's go. Ah. And there is the call for dinner. So I will leave that there. Yeah, I gotta go to dinner now. Probably shouldn't have done this beforehand, but you know, whatever. So I will see you guys in the next stream. It will probably be the Saturday stream. I'm probably not gonna do one Thursday, Friday. But I will see you all next stream. So I hope you have a good day, week, month, and I will see you all in the next stream. Bye.